Hi folks, John Kitz here, playing Sailaway, the sailing simulator. A lot of things are kind of happening today, one of which I am about a day away of finishing this particular scenario. And let me take a look at where I am on the map. If I click on that, you will see, maybe 24 hours away. There's another boat coming up behind me from Florida, following the same track, but they're not seeing my track, they just happen to be following along the same way. So, the other thing that's happening is I have a new headset. It's really good for sound, and not sure how good it is for collecting my vocal distortions. Like every time I swallow, whether it's going to pick that up or not, we will see. But we are recording with a new headset, which is better than the one I had because it was distorting like crazy. It was sounding like it was in a tunnel or something, so I got a better headset after 3 or 4 different tries of headsets. One that I was trying, okay, I want to get rid of that. One that I was trying was, I think it was a 930 headset by Logitech. And it was a really good one, except that it was made out of very light plastic and eventually fell apart after about a year and a half. So I unfortunately had to get rid of that one. So I tried different ones, and finally here I am in this one, which is called something I can't remember. Maybe next time I'll remember for you. But anyway, okay, so here we are. As I say, closing out our round with the Bering Sea, or Bering Strait, or Bering, whoever, well, I know who he was, but he was traveling along in the northern part of the continent trying to find the Bering Strait, or the Northwest Passage, I think. Anyway, so there he is. Now, I've tried various races, and they mostly seem to be just the same race, only a different size. Like, there's a P shape, and they start out with you being directly facing the wind, which is very strange. So I tried those and didn't find them particularly useful, so I skipped a couple days, and here I am once again back here, and I will continue trying different scenarios here and recording them, and also recording some other games, which I'm not sure. I have about 500 games to choose from, so I'll find one of them that will carry us along. Anyway, why are we here? Because I was finding that surfing through YouTube and gaming in general, that adults or mature people or senior people were treated somewhat cruelly and downright poorly in some cases. So I started a channel which is to be considered a safe place for senior people or anyone who is marginalized by the gaming community. And that is pretty much everybody, except a few people who seem to think that they're rulers of the roost. So, if you hit the thumbs up button, we'll be saying you like this video. Or if you hit the subscribe button, well, it says you're liking the video, but you're also liking the channel. And, but most importantly, if you're leaving a comment, please do leave a comment about either the game or your experience with gaming in general. So, here we are, facing the Bering Passage, the Bering Sea. I don't know if it's the Bering Sea or not. I'm scrolling out now. Let me see here. Where the heck are we? Oh, this is the, alright, this is off the coast of Alaska or Asia in that case. So we're going to be passing through here and eventually going through the Northwest Passage, which is, well, it was frozen over, but it's tend to be less frozen over now. But anyway, you can pass through there, given good weather. And so we'll give that a try eventually, maybe. And so here we are. We are going to try to sail away, and we are. The wind is pretty much behind us. So let's go to our trim, and it says the main sheet's too tight. So we'll find the main sheet. Dunningham, Brief, Hall, Jenniker, Backstay, Traveler, main sheet is too tight, so we have to ease it a bit. Alright, so we've eased it a little bit, and it doesn't line up here very well. So, telltales aren't so great. Anyway, let's take a look at her Jenniker. It is as well too tight, so let's find the Jenniker sheet and loosen that a bit. So it wants to collect as much of the wind going by as possible. So the more I loosen it, the more it lines up. So let's go back over to the main sheet. Not really changing a whole lot. You can see by the diagram over here on the right hand side. We'll try to line up the yellow lines with the white lines. It's not telling us why these yellow lines and white lines aren't perfect. So, here we are. Trying to figure out what the heck to do next. Nothing really. We're going to make this a short video, and we're going to travel along this line and eventually cross this line here. And that will be the end of our journey. I guess that's pretty much it. So we are 9 minutes away from reaching our next waypoint, which is this one here. So we're going to go, well, actually we're going to be almost 90 degrees, or 180 degrees downwind. And then the next one we're going to be off again. So rather than that, let's just move that a little closer here. But the wind's going to change, of course, once we start traveling, so we can't watch it every minute of the day, so there's not much we can do. So that is 4.7 nautical miles, it's 4.4 nautical miles, and the next one is 4.5. So we try to keep it under 5 because I've found from sailing in other places, as soon as you get over 5, it increases the chance that you're going to sail off in a totally absurd direction. Probably run into land or sail out to sea or whatever. So we try to keep it under 5. So, there we are. We've made a quick pit stop here in order to let you know that I'm still working on this scenario. And we will see you the next time. So if you hit the thumbs up button, please do. Or the subscribe button. Or most importantly, leave a comment. So until next time, please do. Take care.